energy is a major driver of expansion. So the availability of what is effectively an enormous energy subsidy, a huge energy inheritance that we simply discovered, the effect of that has been to enable an enormous period of expansion. And with expansion comes the development of extremely complex societies. So energy has been a major driver of socioeconomic complexity, social differentiation, the building of hierarchies. All of that has been enabled by energy. But energy, I would argue, is not going to be the cause of what the financial crisis that we're going to go through now. It's been an enabler of complexity, and finance is part of that. But you don't have to have a massive energy subsidy to blow a bubble. Bubbles have existed from all the way back to antiquity and beyond. I've written about a number of historical bubbles that came long before the fossil fuel era. So although energy increases the odds of blowing a bubble, it's not actually necessary for blowing a bubble, and it's not a lack of energy that makes a bubble burst. So if we look at the 1930s, the Depression, Great Depression, in America, people said, well, we have everything except money. They were the global swing producer for oil. They had a virgin continent's worth of resources. They had cheap labor everywhere. So it wasn't a lack of resources that caused the Depression. And it won't be a lack of resources that caused the Depression this time either, because the impact of financial crisis is so quick that finance will be the key driver to the downside. Further on, that will cause a substantial supply contraction for oil, but it's more a question that financial crisis will drive energy crisis than the other way around.